this is H.G. Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! Well, let's report our failure again to the king. Didn't get the crystals back. Oh, really? Huh? He's just sleeping. He's not dead. Oh, okay. It's a bearded lady. Hey, how's it going? Nah, basically nothing's changed in the last 2 hours. Well, we did kill all the 4 fiends. Oh. Well, then what's the point of putting a seal there if it can just be broken like that? What's going on? Take it off. Now. Oh! Oh, okay. Well, there we go. But we can't get over to the sealed cave. I didn't see any caves around here. So, okay, but we can't fly over lava. Whatever shall we do? Oh, really? Huh. Well, Rydia did find her way down here, somehow. Well, she was taken here, against her will, but other than that. Tamra, huh? Maybe we should check that out. Nuts. Well, then how do you know they're there? What do you use, a telescope? Well, he blew himself up. But first things first. Since last time I already sold all my excess equipment off screen there. And do I still have some Gasal greens? I think I do. Yes, okay, good. Because there are some things I want to deposit and take out. Good thing I deposited so many things before, because I almost ran out of inventory space. Let's see. Want to deposit those. Blood sword? Eh, maybe I'll use it later. Someone was suggesting an instance where I could use it. Let's get the silencing arrows back out. Want to get the ruby rings? We'll definitely want those. And the killer bow. If you do not have the ruby rings, have fun! But they do make life a lot easier. They said he was here. Hey! He's alive! Of course he can survive explosions of preposterous magnitude. He must be made of preposterone. No, just... He's really, really tough. I'm guessing it's like a Dragon Ball sort of thing, where people can survive feats of superhuman strength. Watch your mouth. Or wash your mouth. You want to become his whipping boy? Did they have those in real life? That sounds hard to believe. I mean, even back then. I guess he's his own whipping boy. Well, it's not like they're together or anything, or ever will. Yeah, pretty much, you sacrificed yourself for nothing, basically. Yeah, it's an inferior model. Yeah, pretty much. You still got those goggles on, though? I mean, you'd figure you'd take, what are those, like welding goggles or something? I used to do that stuff back in the day, back in college. But then they wouldn't pay me for it. Yeah, you guys just push him along. Ah. Well, there we go. Yeah, I heard that was like... So, you see all these fake-out deaths. Like, with Edward, and Rydia, and Cid there. My guess is... And from what I heard, they were going to... For... When they were, like, figuring out the story and everything like that with this game. They were basically going for, like... Sort of like an interactive manga sort of thing, which, well, obviously Dragon Ball was really popular at the time there. Or, I think they were on Dragon Ball Z by then. But, still, you get the idea. So, I'm guessing that's how they justify the whole superhuman feat survival thing, whatever. So, me, personally, it doesn't bother me at all. Oh, they cut that out. Well, usually one of the dwarves, like, falls off the bridge there. Or almost falls off. in a humorous attempt. Yeah, I just think the pacing of the plot is just so good. It's just one epic scene after another that, well, I overlook the whole fake-out death thing. If it bothers you that much, well, you're missing out. Oh well. Can't be everyone's favorite game, I suppose. Well, thanks a lot. So, yeah, now we can basically go over lava. How's it going? Oh, if you talked to them before, they would have said, oh, he eats a lot, but... He complains about our food, but he eats a lot. Or something like that. So, okay, well, let's go exploring the rest of the underworld. We can pretty much go anywhere. Obviously, it's not nearly as big as the overworld, but, well, you take what you can get. So, let's head on down here first. Let's see who's in this place. Cockle, Cockle, Forge, however you pronounce it, I don't know. How's it going? Oh. Well, that's not good. Now let's go raid his place. If he's not making anything, I'm sure he doesn't need anything. Maybe he can make a new weapon for us? Let's find out. Nothing over there. Hey. There we go. See, I think... Yes, here we get a summon drop. It boosts your MP by 10. So, let's give it to Edge there. He could use the MP more. I mean, obviously, Rosa and Rydia got plenty, so they're not going to be fine. Or, I mean, they're not going to have any problems. They're already fine. Remember that for later, viewers. Adamantite. Now, if you're playing the Super Nintendo version, you can go through a secret passage to the right there. When you're, like, right on the stairs. But for some reason, they took it out of this version of the game. So, I don't know why. But, oh well. Now let's go check out that town, Tamra. Let's see, right over there. There we go. See if they got some new stuff for us. How's it going? Oh. Yeah, I suppose if you're used to having lava everywhere, that would be kind of disgusting. Oh, so that's where it is. Huh. Maybe we should check it out. And the sylphs, really? Wow, they got all sorts of strange creatures down here. So this is the point in the game where you actually have some side quests that you can do. Nice areas to explore. Amazing treasure to find. Yeah, they lowered the price of the inn here. It used to be, I think, 1200 or something? I don't know. But, yeah. But yeah, so they're not so much side quests, but extra areas that you can explore and give a little more deep background on the plot. So I really like how they handle that in this game. Now, at this point, I'd like to get 20 antidotes. See, let's get 20 maiden's kisses. Want to get... I think that's everything on this one. See, let's buy some more Phoenix Downs. We're going to need a lot of those. Pretty much almost no matter what you do. Yeah, let's get a bunch of those. And Remedies, let's get up to 20 of those. That ought to do. I'm going to list all this in the video description, so you don't need to take notes. I'll list it there. And I'm also going to list my recommended setup in the video description there, too. Howdy-ho! Okay, lally-ho or rally-ho or hi-ho, I could understand. But where does howdy-ho come from? They didn't use that in... What was that show? Tool Time, or whatever it was called. The show with Tim at Home Improvement, that was it. They didn't say that in that show, did they? I thought he was, what did his neighbor say? I forget what he always said. I thought he said Heidi-ho, not Howdy-ho, or something like that. I don't know, I haven't watched that show in years. No, you just live in a giant rock. What do you think? Okay, well, I think that's everything we can do here, so let's go buy some more equipment. Oh, by the way, one thing about that... I forgot to equip these. Silencing arrows. The killer bow boosts your strength by 5, so that's pretty nice. Wish I had one more point, but oh well. If you didn't save the killer bow, there's more. Let's see, we want to get, let's say, another 40 silencing arrows. That ought to be pretty nice. Yeah, just equip them and they add themselves to your inventory. And then we want to get a whole bunch of new equipment. So let's get diamond shields, diamond helms, diamond armors, diamond gloves. And if you don't have a gold hairpin for Rydia, you could get that. And I want to get a diamond armor for later because it's the only way that you can give edge resistance to lightning. So let's equip all that stuff. Equip all that stuff. I'll sell everything off screen there. And let's see. You know what? Let's do it today. I was thinking about saving it for later, but I could go for a little length on today's episode. There's a bunch of new enemies around here. There's the sealed cave, by the way, if you just want to continue on with the plot, you can go there. There's the Feymark, if you want to go there, but I don't want to go there yet. And let's see, way up here is the Cave of the Sylphs, or Sylph Cave, or whatever they call it in this game. The Sylph Cave, yeah. Now, if you go right here, there's some very unique enemies you can run into around here, so let's check them out. Let's see if this is one of them. Okay, maybe that wasn't one of them, I don't know. Well, let's try that one again. And it's not even so much that these enemies are, like, really rare around... Hit the guy! There we go. It's not so much that they're rare, just that... you can't meet up with them anywhere else. And it's in such a tiny patch of land. Kain, can you finish the job? Thank you. Okay, let's see if I can actually meet up with the enemies this time around. But yeah, just this area is called the Three-Step Peninsula. Or at least that's what we like to call it. If it's not a new enemy this time, I'll just do it off-screen. Okay, well, there's one of them, the Alrauni, something like that. I don't know how you pronounce it. But anyway, that one, let's see, that one is weak to throw elemental attacks. So, oh, that could hurt. Well, not that bad. Still, let's see, what else is it weak to? Well, you can toad it, so let's do that. So you could also use arrows against it. Those are obviously throw elemental. Well, obviously. Yeah, that's how you deal with her. Easy enough. Where are you, Kain? You're gonna come down for the party, right? There we go. So yeah, you can't meet up with this one anywhere else in the game around here. There's a couple other battles I'd like to show here, too. Okay, here's another one. I think it's the green one in the background there is the Gorgon. If I'm not mistaken. Can't meet up with her anywhere else besides here. Nothing too special about them. As a matter of fact, let's shoot bile against them. You could use Toad on them if you so choose, but since I'm not really worried about my MP at this point, I'm just going to go with the brute force method. No elemental weakness or anything else that we can exploit. I'd fast forward, but I'm too afraid that I'm going to reset my game. Don't fast forward while recording. Learned that lesson twice already. There we go! Finally found them. Took forever to find them. For some reason, we got two new enemies. Well, maybe not quite the last two, but you know what I mean. We got Gloomwings and Hornworms. And you can't meet up with them anywhere else. Let's see, the Bloodflower you can meet up with elsewhere. They're weak to fire! But I'm just going to use Titan to take out the hornworms rather quickly. As you can see, they fly, so we can't really do a whole lot about the Gloomwing with Titan there. Oh well. But they are weak to throw. Let's see. They're also susceptible to Toad, if you want to use that. Oh, nice shades you got there, Rydia. Holy cow. Alright, we learned Haste. Nice. And... I don't have any eye drops, so we'll just have to do that the old-fashioned way. Now, there is one more new enemy that you can meet up around here. It is ultra-rare, but... Oh. Is this the one? Huh. I forget. Holy crap, it is the right one! Okay, Shadowbag. Okay, whew. I forgot. Oops. But yeah, it's a yellow dragon. I forgot that you meet up with them as an egg at first, but, well, there we go. So, yeah, get hold or shadow bind on them. They'll do the same thing. And you can basically keep them in place. Otherwise, they will use some lightning thunder attack on you over and over again. If you don't have the siren or don't have the patience to find it otherwise, we'll be able to meet up with later. But can we break the seal on the sealed cave to save the crystal? Or should we do side quests? Find out next time on Let's Play Final Fantasy IV! This is H.G. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day! Yeah, let's rest up here.